Bangkok's Lumpini Park is a pleasant 142-acre space in the heart of Thailand's capital. Of course, any urban green space is to be cherished, but one even more so in a busy city of over 8 million people. Lumpini Park serves as a needed respite from the hustle of Bangkok's streets and sidewalks. It's a place where people can sit, exercise, or check out some of the many activities on offer every day. But Lumpini Park is more than just an inexpensive diversion that appeals to virtually everyone. The space is home to a number of permanent facilities and seasonal activities. Locals and tourists alike are drawn to the park for things to do beyond just lounging around or picnics. Lumpini Park gets its name from Lumpini, the birthplace of Siddhartha Gautama, later to become Buddha, in Nepal. The space was set aside from royal land in the 1920s, and then later turned into Bangkok's first park. During World War II, Thailand was invaded by Japanese forces in 1941, and Japanese soldiers actually used Lumpini Park as a camp, after which allies bombed the city. The statue of King Rama VI, the king responsible for creating the park, was erected in 1942. Today, it's a popular spot for Bangkokians to meet up, exercise, or just relax amongst the trees and ponds. Although the 142 acres, or 57.6 hectares, of park are generous, an estimated 15,000 people pass through daily. Don't expect to have very much privacy. Along with permanent attractions such as an outdoor gym, indoor dance hall, and library, Bangkok's first, a number of groups meet in the park to share activities. Weekends are particularly eventful, and most clubs meet in the evenings when the heat is more tolerable. Early mornings are especially busy as people come to exercise. Jogging two circuits of the park is roughly the same as completing a 5K. So, what all can you do in Lumpini Park? Exercise? You can jog, cycle, and rollerblade in the park. You'll likely find older groups practicing Tai Chi in the mornings. And before sunset, you can sweat it out at the park's free aerobic sessions to high-energy techno tunes. All of these activities are typically free to join. Rent a boat. Ever wanted to ride along with your significant other in a tacky giant swan? Here's your chance. Yellow rubber duckies and rowboats are also options. Meet people. Many varied interests bring groups together in Lumpini Park. You can take advantage of an opportunity to meet locals and participate. You'll see clusters of people from local birdwatching clubs, photography clubs, and more. Strangers may even want to practice their English by striking up a conversation. Enjoy the music. During the dry season, or winter months, the orchestra plays free shows on weekend evenings. At other times, you'll catch different types of music and even karaoke. All are typically free to enjoy. The giant monitor lizards that call the lake home may look like Komodo dragons, but thankfully aren't dangerous. They are, however, in the same family as their venomous cousins and can have a nasty temperament when cornered. The Thai word for these lizards, hia, also serves as a profane insult. So in other words, it's best to leave them alone. For years, the monitor lizards in Lumpini Park have grown in size and audacity, both attracting and spooking Western visitors. It's estimated that there are around 400 monitor lizards in Lumpini Park. The lizards are actually part of the ecosystem, serving as scavengers who clean up dead fish, birds, and other creatures. Although monitor lizards aren't dangerous, they do grow to frightening sizes. Some are close to 3 meters long. For obvious reasons, you shouldn't attempt to feed or interact with them in any way. They are still wild animals, so treat them with respect. There are a few more things you should know before visiting Lumpini Park. Park hours are from 4:30 a.m. to 10 p.m. Smoking is prohibited throughout the park. Tourists are frequently caught and fined, so don't do it. Dogs are not allowed. Cycling is allowed from 10 a.m. until 3 p.m. Wi-Fi can be found throughout the park, but the signal strength varies. Sleeping in the park isn't permitted, although you can get away with a nap. Lumpini Park is centrally located in Bangkok. The quickest way to get there is by train, unless you're coming from Khao San Road. Most of Lumpini Park is surrounded by walls, so you'll need to enter through one of the six gates. The main entrance is the one in the southwestern corner near the Royal Monument and MRT station. The Siloam MRT station, Blue Line, is located in the southwestern corner of Lumpini Park. The Lumpini MRT station is at the southeastern corner. The nearest BTS SkyTrain station is Solidang, just a little south of Lumpini Park. Solidang is located along the BTS Siloam line. If you're coming from the Sukhumvit line, which is often the case, you would need to change lines at the Siam BTS station. Alternatively, Lumpini Park is about a 5 to 10 minute walk from Plernchit BTS station on the Sukhumvit line. Lumpini Park is around 90 minutes of a hot walk from the Khao San Road area. Going by taxi is easiest. Some drivers will refuse to use the meter. If this happens, simply flag another. But if you've never taken a tuk-tuk ride in Bangkok, this is your chance. Just know that tuk-tuks are typically more hassle, less comfortable, and no cheaper for tourists than a meter taxi. But doing so at least once is kind of a tourist rite of passage. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like or comment. And if you'd like to see more from TravSite, click subscribe, then the bell, to be notified of future uploads. Thanks for watching!